Hello students, welcome to the Science Online class. In this class, we are going to study a new lesson. What is the lesson name? The World of Living. The World of Living. We depend on the plants, we already know that. Yes? But the point is that, why we are depending on the plants? Okay? What do we get? Some special materials from the plants and how they are so important to us. For example, oxygen. So oxygen is very, very important to survive for all the living things. Yes? And during this pandemic we have seen how important oxygen is for us. Okay, we know that we cannot survive even for the 2 to 3 minutes without oxygen. Okay, some people they can survive. So more than that, it is not possible. So oxygen is very, very important. But how this oxygen comes in our atmosphere? From where? Yes, very good. From the plants. But the question raises that, how plants they produce oxygen? How? What is the process involved in it? And which part of the plant they use to produce oxygen? We are going to learn all these important concepts in this lesson. Okay? So the world of living, we are going to study photosynthesis in green plants. What is this photosynthesis process? What are the factors that affect this photosynthesis process? And what are the necessary conditions for photosynthesis process, and parts of a leaf, and how plant or how a leaf produces food, and how does it help to itself and at the same time to every living organism. Okay? So let's see that. The first one, photosynthesis in green plants. What is this photosynthesis? Photosynthesis. So photo means light. Okay? So synthesis means putting together all the materials. What are those, sir? Generally, the process of producing food by the leaves of the plant is called photosynthesis process. Yes, plants they can produce their own food. How about we, sir? No, we cannot produce our own food. So we are depending on the plants. Yes, we are omnivores. We depend on the plants and we depend on the animals like goat, sheep, yes, and chicken. So photo means light, synthesis means putting together. So how this leaf produces food? It needs some materials. What are those, sir? So as we know that, so we breathe out carbon dioxide and we breathe in oxygen. But plants require this carbon dioxide. Yes. For what reason? They require this carbon dioxide to produce food. So they use this carbon dioxide in the production of the food process, and that process is called as photosynthesis process. Okay? Only carbon dioxide, sir? No. Plants require so many other factors also. What are those? Sunlight. Here what we are discussing here, photo. Photo means light, especially sunlight. So plants, they absorb energy from the sun and they transform that energy to the, to whom? To us. Okay? So solar energy is transmitted to the every living organism that depends on the plants. Okay? So photo means light, synthesis means putting together. Here I said that carbon dioxide and sunlight. Okay? Carbon dioxide, sunlight, and other than that, there is One important factor, what is that? A colored pigment, what is its name? That is chlorophyll. What is that? Chlorophyll. Before to introduce this word, I have to ask you one question. What is that? Very simple. Why leaves are generally in green color? Very good. Why? Due to the presence of the chlorophyll in the leaves. So chlorophyll is present in the leaves. So that's the reason leaves are in the green color. Then you may have a doubt. Sir, I have seen so many leaves which are not in the green color. What about them? Very good. So some leaves of the plants, they may are in the different colors, like red, yellow, the combination of green and red, the combination of green and yellow. Remember that in the plant, especially in the leaves, where the green color is present, there chlorophyll is present. And to produce the food, the presence of chlorophyll is must. Okay? So in the leaf, if any part of the leaf there is no chlorophyll, in such case, in that place, leaf cannot produce the food. So the part of the leaf where chlorophyll is present, there it can produce the food. Okay? But in some plants, in some leaves, chlorophyll is behind the other colors. For example, as I said just now, some leaves are in red color, some leaves are in combination of both colors, yellow, green. So some leaves are in red color. So below the red color, okay, below the red color, chlorophyll is present. It does not mean that the leaves, they do not have chlorophyll. It does not mean that. Chlorophyll is present, but that chlorophyll is covered with the another pigment, red colored pigment. So that red colored pigment is dominating the chlorophyll, but still chlorophyll is present in the leaves. Hope you understand. So finally, carbon dioxide, sunlight, chlorophyll, and what is the another important factor? Very good. Water. Water. How important water to the plant? How water is so important? First of all, plants, they absorb nutrients, minerals from the, not from the soil, from water. Sir, but actually, nutrients and minerals, they are present in the soil. Then, how do they absorb nutrients and minerals from the water? Yes, actually, nutrients and minerals are present in the soil, ma. But these nutrients and minerals, they dissolve in the water. So the dissolved minerals and nutrients are absorbed by the plants, okay, through the roots, and then after stem, it carries these nutrients to the every part of the, every cell of the plant. Okay. So finally, here we have seen four important factors that can affect photosynthesis. Okay. Carbon dioxide, sunlight, chlorophyll, water. If any one of these options, if any one of these is not present in the leaf, or if any one of these does not involve in the process of photosynthesis, in such case, leaves, they cannot produce food. Yes? Sir, but initially, you have started the lesson, releasing of oxygen from the leaves. But you are discussing here about the production of food. Yes. Actually, what happens? When leaves produce the food, the release of oxygen is the byproduct. Yes. So in this photosynthesis process, leaves, they produce food, and at the same time, leaves releases oxygen, which is very, very, very important to the every living organism on the earth. Yes. So this is how generally leaf is very, very important for the production of the food itself. Okay. So how leaf is important to the plant, we understand now. So now let's see here parts of a leaf. Okay. So this part is called stalk. Okay. Stalk, and it is connected to the stem of the plant. And this is main vein, Okay, so you can see this is completely, this is all main vein, and it is also called as midrib. And these are lateral veins, these, okay, and the space is called leaf blade, this complete space, the space between the veins, this is called leaf blade, okay. And among all this, one important part of the leaf, what is that? Stomata. What is that? Stomata. So stomata is nothing but a hole under the leaf. It generally present the lower part of the leaf. For example, this is the upper part. The lower part of the leaves consist of so many stomatas, so many holes. And generally we consider the stomata as nose of the leaf. Why, sir? Why do we consider this stomata as nose of the leaf? Generally, what do we do with our nose? Tell me. Breathe in, breathe out. Yes, we breathe in oxygen and we breathe out carbon dioxide. Okay, so we use our nose to exchange gases. Yes, to exchange the gases, we use our nose. In the similar way, this stomata is also helpful to the leaf to exchange gases. Okay, leaf releases oxygen and it absorbs carbon dioxide. Okay, so this is how about the photosynthesis process and how leaf is important in the process of photosynthesis, and we required all these factors which involves in the photosynthesis process. Next, we have seen photosynthesis parts of a leaf. How do plants use their food? How do plants use their food? For example, mango. Yes, it stores its food in the form of the starches. Okay, so generally you might have liked mangoes. Yes, most of the people, they like mangoes. Me too. So all the plants, after the production of the food, they store their food in different parts of their body. When it is extra, first of all, when the food is produced, this production of the food, this produced food is used to get energy for the plant. Yes, to get energy for the plant, and at the same time for its growth. Growth. Okay, so after food is used in the purpose of energy and for the growth, after these two, if any food is present extra, then plant, it stores its food in different parts of the plant. But it depends on the plant, ma. Some plants, they store their food, excessive food, in the roots. Some plants, they store their excessive food in the branches, and some plants, they store their excessive food in the leaves, okay, and in the flowers, this way. Let me tell you some examples. What are those? For example, the plants that stores food in the roots, like carrot, radish, beetroot, yes, these are some examples. And especially these are called as tubers. What do we call? We call them as tubers. Okay, next, plants that stores their food in their branches or stem. What are those? Sugarcane, potato. These are generally, they store their excessive food in the stems. Next, leaves like spinach, cabbage. These are leaves. Next, in flowers like broccoli, cauliflower. These are some examples. So first, plants, they undergo the process of photosynthesis. During this process of photosynthesis, they produce food, and during this process, oxygen also releases. Okay, and after the production of the food, that food is used for the energy purpose and for its growth. And the excessive food is stored in different parts of the plant. And in this photosynthesis process, leaf plays a vital role. Okay, so stemmata are present the lower part of the leaf. The important parts of the leaf are, this is stalk, main vein, okay, and next, this is main vein also called as midrib, and this is leaf blade. Now, how to test presence of starch? Presence of starch. For example, as I am seeing that sunlight is very important. Yes, sunlight is very important. Then, how to prove this experimentally? How to prove this? Very simple activity. What is that, sir? Just you first take an healthy plant, a healthy plant. Okay? After taking a healthy plant, you pluck a leaf. Okay? A leaf. And then after, just first you cover the leaf with the black strips of paper or black strips of cloth, your wish. Okay? So what you have to do that, you keep that in the dark room for 2 to 3 days. For 2 to 3 days. And then after, again take out that and keep it in sunlight. Remember, actually we should not pluck it in the first. Okay? First, it should be on the plant itself. We will cover the leaf with the strips of black paper, and then after we will shift it to the dark room, and then after 2 to 3 days we will bring back into the sunlight. Okay? And after that, what happens? After one day or after some time, now you can pluck that leaf which is covered with the black strips, and then after you can test with the iodine solution. What is this iodine solution? Generally we use this iodine solution to test the presence of starch. Yes, to test the presence of starch. So when you drop iodine solution on the leaves, okay, so if it turns into blue black color, then starch is present in the leaves. If it turns into the brown color, then there is no starch in the leaf. So we use this iodine solution to test the presence of starch in the leaves. Understand? But in this testing of the presence of starch, we have to follow a procedure. What is that procedure? For example, first you have to pluck the leaves, and then after boil the leaves in alcohol. Why, sir? Because when you boil in the alcohol, the cells in the leaf, they die, and the even chlorophyll also dissolves in the alcohol. And now you can test that leaf with the iodine solution, then you can notice the color clearly. But when this green color pigment is present, you cannot see, you cannot identify the color easily. So that's why first here we are removing that, we are removing the chlorophyll from the leaves, and then after we'll test with the iodine solution. So when you drop iodine solution on the leaf, then it turns into blue black color. Okay, so remember this. So now let's recall what we have learned in this class. Here we have seen photosynthesis in green plants, and then after parts of a leaf, how do plants use their food, okay, and factors that involve in the photosynthesis process, how to test presence of starch with iodine solution, and how important is sunlight. Okay, I have explained an activity. Okay, and how important is chlorophyll? This is also super easy an activity. Very easy. How, sir? Just take a leaf which is in the combination of different colors, like yellow green, red green. Okay, now boil the leaf in the alcohol. Okay, now drop iodine solution on the leaf. Where green part is present on the leaf, there it turns blue black color, and the rest of the part of the leaf, okay, and the rest of the leaf, it does not turn into blue black color. Okay, so this is how we can understand or we can prove the importance of sunlight in the photosynthesis process, chlorophyll in photosynthesis process. Okay, now, so we have seen all these important topics here. and I'll see you again with another topic from this lesson itself in our next class. Hope you understand. See you again.